Hi, I'm Don Mecoy. I'm business editor of the Oklahoman and News OK. Joined today by Mark Funke, the CEO of Southwest Bank Corp, which is the parent company of Bank SNB, one of the largest banks in the state of Oklahoma. Welcome to the newsroom, Mark.
Thanks, Don. I appreciate being here.
Thanks for joining us. You guys made a little news this week. Tell us
we
about
did.
This.
We did. We're excited about it. It is it's the first acquisition that our team has been able to make. I joined the company, Southwest Bank Corp, as CEO 2.5 years ago, and we've spent the last 2.5 years putting the company in a position to make an announcement like this. And it takes the work and effort of a lot of people, but I think it was the appropriate time for us to be able to make an acquisition. We're one of three public banks in the state, and so everything that we do is financially is out there in the public, and everyone knows about it. So we have to be cautious and careful about the moves that we make and the steps that we take in order to grow the organization, and we're excited about this one.
Well, and you have planned to purchase another bank. I think it's a $41 million deal, as you say. This is all public information.
Sure.
Tell us a little bit about the bank you're purchasing.
Well, we're acquiring, Southwest Bank Corp will acquire First Commercial Bank shares. First Commercial Bank shares is the parent to First Commercial Bank of Oklahoma. And they're about a $305 to $10 million banking organization, headquartered actually in Edmond, Oklahoma. They have 5 branches in and around the city, and then they also have 4 branches in Colorado. 3 in Denver and 1 in Colorado Springs. So what this does for Bank SNB is it certainly broadens our footprint and our reach in the Oklahoma City market, but also allows us to take our brand to Colorado, and we're very excited about that.
Well, and you're sort of becoming a little bit of a regional bank.
Very much so. Well, we have offices in Oklahoma, Kansas, and Texas, and this will add one more piece to our footprint, but a contiguous state. We like Colorado because Denver certainly is a high-growth market, much like a Dallas or an Austin. And Colorado Springs represents a great opportunity for our company as well. And I know the Oklahoman certainly has interest from a Colorado perspective at the Broadmoor and things of that nature. So we're very excited about the opportunity this brings to us. But most importantly for Oklahoma City, this really does represent an opportunity for Bank SNB to spread its brand in the Oklahoma City market area. We already have 4 branches here, so this will more than double our opportunity to reach out to our customer base in Oklahoma City.
Well, tell us a little bit about what this might mean for your new customers and your new employees. Is it going to have any impact on them?
Well, for right now, no. And that's only because while we announced the acquisition today, it doesn't officially take place until we get regulatory approval. And we're going through that process now. And it'll take several months because we'll have to have approval of the Federal Reserve and the Oklahoma State Banking Commission. But we've already had conversations with them on a very favorable basis, and they're certainly aware of this. We'll file our application process, and it'll probably take 2 to 3 months before we actually have the approval from the regulators to do that. So in the interim, in that period of time between now and when that happens, customers at First Commercial Bank will see the exact same thing they've seen over the years, good customer service from their employees, and they'll continue to run their bank accordingly. But during the next 3 months or so, we'll be working with them to strategize an integration process that will merge First Commercial Bank into Bank SNB so that whenever the approval comes forth and we can actually close the transaction, we'll be prepared to put new Bank SNB signs on their facilities and bring their customers into our product set. So we're excited about that. But in the interim, the next few months, really no changes at all for the First Commercial Bank or their employees.
Okay. Well, now, is this deal a part of a long-term strategy for Bank SNB?
Well, it is a long-term strategy, but it's a very calculated strategy. As a public company, we have to be very aware of dilution of our shareholders if we are to make an acquisition. In this case, the acquisition includes 51% stock and 49% cash. So our shareholders that currently exist for Southwest Bank Corp are slightly diluted, but only by 4%, which is a number that we felt very comfortable with and our existing shareholder base felt comfortable with as well. So yes, we're interested in growth, but we're also mainly interested in focusing on making sure this transaction goes very well, that the customers of First Commercial Bank are integrated appropriately and smoothly into Bank SNB, and we don't have any problems associated with that at all. But going forward, yes, Bank SNB is very interested in growth. We're in 4 really good growth states, and hopefully we'll have the opportunity to grow the organization in the future.
Well, as a company that has strong Oklahoma roots and also now has a more of a regional look to it. Mm-hmm. Give me your thoughts on what you think about the state economy and the region economy, what's going on now. We saw just this week that earnings were really good for state mm-hmm. banks in the first quarter, despite kind of a weakening energy sector. Tell me what your thoughts are on that area.
You know, I think the I certainly wouldn't put the economy as robust, but I would put it as favorable. We have good growth. You know, if you look at a city like Oklahoma City, really low unemployment. We have positive news on a fairly regular basis with companies moving to town or expanding. And if you look at a Dallas and an Austin and San Antonio, other markets that we're in, we're seeing the same thing. Yes, we are in an energy state, we are in an energy sector, but energy is going to continue to be an important part of our economy, particularly in this region. And while you're going to see cycles like we've seen here recently with a drop in oil prices, I think the economy is going to remain reasonably strong. I don't see oil prices going up to $100, but that's probably okay. If they stay in this range where we are today, in that $55 to say $65 range, I think the companies that are in the oil and gas business are going to continue to flourish. Businesses that support that will do well, and businesses around this sector will do well. So I'm not saying we have a robust economy, but I think we have a decent economy that allow banks like us to grow and companies in the market to grow.
Okay. Well, thanks for sharing that. And
sure.
Again, thanks for coming into the
you
newsroom
bet.
Today. It's always a pleasure to talk to you. There's more business coverage every day in the Oklahoman and here on News OK.